Before I had MS, I was an escaped lawyer, as I like to say. Once I decided that profession was not for me, I paid off my student loans and I ended up in the independent music business. And I began managing bands and helping them run their own record labels. So I was managing two rock bands and a singer-songwriter, and everything was great. I told my bands, you know what, I was just diagnosed with MS. I don't know if I can do this work anymore. At that point, fatigue was my most serious symptom. And I decided, well, let me just try to find a job that can work around my fatigue symptoms. And so I took a job at an investment bank where I was able to do full-time hours in 3 days, basically take care of myself and rest the other 4 days. I did that until 2008, and then the financial crash happened. And right after the crash, I was laid off, and I first started experiencing real physical disability. And I said to myself, let me start trying to help other people. What can I do? So I started volunteering for the MS Society, and I met a friend actually at an MS walk. I was discussing a photography project that I wanted to do, and it turns out that she used to be a celebrity makeup artist. And we got together and we were running a program of workshops called Makeover Your MS. We'd have professional makeup artists come in and do their makeup. And we would do these wonderful photo shoots, and they got these beautiful pictures. And what that led to was my wanting to work with women with MS on a regular basis. And so I founded Rockstar Women with MS. And then I wrote my book, Overcome the BS of MS, which is a handbook which I felt was something I wish I had had when I was first diagnosed, because it shows, no, you don't have to give up. So between that book and Rockstar Women with MS, I started developing this online support network for women. And this past year, I did my life coach training. My one great success story is a woman that I coached earlier this year. She said that she had gone from living in just 3 rooms of her house to now getting out and engaging more. And she's even starting a venture that helps other people with disabilities. It's really interesting how things can go full circle, because back when I was working with the bands, that was my job. Promote them, help them put their best foot forward, and I feel that's what I'm doing now. So my background, my former life, actually supports what I'm doing in my current life.